Hi, this is Tom from Coherent Logic. I'm going to take you through the installation and some use cases for the Coherent data feed for the Thomson Reuters Elektron platform. So let's start. We have one dependency here, which is not provided by the package, and that's the RFA dependency. I've renamed it simply so that we can see the version number. And that's sitting in my temp folder. So step one, we need to install the package, and I'll do that now. So one thing I've not mentioned, I already have the RJava and RJSON.io packages installed. So I will skip that step. The next step, once this package has been installed, is to execute this line here, because we need to be able to tell the package that there's an extra dependency. And we do that by setting the cDataFeedJarsList option. So that's complete. This message here is telling you effectively about the next line of code that we're going to execute, and that is this one. So we'll execute this now. That's done. Now we can call the library and load it. And that's good. So now that we're ready to work with the library, we need to take one extra step. This needs to be done exactly one time, and that is that we need to initialize the library. Okay, so we will now log in to Thomson Reuters Elektron. That's this line here. And we're done. So we'll work with some time series data in this step. So I have the RIC for CSCO, and I set the period to monthly. Go ahead and execute this, and I'm going to execute this all the way up to this line here. And you can see this plot here. So there's two other options. We have daily and weekly. Try this. And we have weekly. Okay. Now that that's done, we can try any of the available RICs that Thomson Reuters offers. But I think that gets the point across. So the next step for us is to take a look at some other functionality that's provided. And that is collecting real-time market price updates from Thomson Reuters. And we can query any number of symbols that we want in this case. But depending on how much power your machine has, your performance may vary. So here's what we need to do. First step, we need to query, and I'll run that. Okay, so we're done. And now in this next step, all we're gonna do is print the update. And I won't do anything with the update because then that gets into analysis, and this is just a very brief, basic introduction. So here we go. And this is no longer needed. And you can see the update streaming in. Let me show you another feature. So this is using Java to make the call to Thomson Reuters. And that means that we can connect to the virtual machine using the JConsole tool. And we can take a look at some of the stats. Okay, that's our process. So we know that this is the process because we're using InfiniSpan and HornetQ internally. So when we connect, we can take a look at some of the memory usage as well as the number of threads, classes, and CPU usage. And for this example, we're not really processor heavy. And memory is pretty decent as well. And for our M-beans, we can take a look at HornetQ. And you can see our messages added and the current message count in the queue. And it will go up and down depending on how busy it is. So that's our brief introduction. I won't keep you. Thanks for your time. If you have questions, you can put them in the comment section, and I'd be happy to help you.